people. Perry here with another episode of Surviving Creatively. And can you guess where I am? Huh? Take a look around. I'm actually not that far away from our castle area here. It's just some random cave that will be probably covered up at some point in time. It's kind of interesting when you're MC editing all over the place. You start to take away a lot of the terrain, and then you start to expose a little bit of the underneath here, the caves, and you know, it would make for some interesting builds. A cave one day, I'll have to wrap my head around that, but just looking at the shapes and how they kind of twist and turn, especially with the whole cutaway with MC Edit, I think, I don't know, it's an idea that maybe one day we could do. I don't know, just throwing that out there. But we're still here in our palace area. We're working on the castle, but I did want to show you a little bit about what I've been doing. You can see some orange wool over there. I've been sort of planning out the next steps in the whole palace. I didn't want to, you know, record any of that. That's all planning stuff. That's, you know, it's all things that you guys really don't need to see. The castle is coming along, and I think I was a little bit too optimistic about my choice of castle here, because it is very complex. This part right here is pretty easy to build. It's very symmetrical. There's a lot of things that repeat themselves, so I don't have that much trouble, only in that I wanted to come up with the design, and we pretty much have done that. You can see that the crenellations that we've made here, I've decided to keep the sandstone. The sandstone kind of works. It's different. I wanted something different for the castle. It was mainly for just to be different. I don't know how else to put it, but just to be different. So I'm using just the regular sandstone here, and then couple that with the, what's that? That's the smooth sandstone. All of these things, it kind of, the two different textures are something that I think will really work well. And it kind of gives a nice break in between the whole castle structure. If the crenellations were gray in color, I think it might get kind of lost in translation. So the whiteness or the yellowness of the sandstone really stands out, and it calls attention to it. So that's really key when we're going to put in our details here. And you can see some of the other things that I've been doing to kind of break up the monotony of the brick wall is these right here. And they are kind of, I want to think of them more of as structural elements, and you know, it's also a good detail element in that it kind of, like I said, breaks up the monotony of the entire structure, so we don't have the boring gray brick going throughout. And it echoes itself down over there, and you'll see that this, it doesn't go down all the way, and that's because there's going to be bits of the palace that'll be going over top of it. I just wanted to extend it down just a little bit, just so I can get a good feel of the whole design. And working out the spacing in between all of this, it's a little bit difficult here and there, but you kind of play around with everything and trying to keep everything nice and centered. That's real important. So once you get your center point, and then you can kind of work your way out from there. And that's how I kind of work with these sort of things, especially when I want to keep things nice and symmetrical. So I've also worked on this, and I think it's been so long since I've recorded an episode, I forgot where I left off exactly. But this tower right here, which is going to be real key for the defense of the castle, and this is where it starts to get a little bit complicated with the whole castle structure and the design of it. This part that kind of sticks out, it's going to be a real focal element, especially from this area. It's going to be a nice imposing structure for us to take a look at. And I wanted to make sure that the crenellations kind of curved around this area and over here, that curved back into the castle, kind of connects the castle to this part quite nicely. And then we move on to this area, which I have been kind of muddling around with snot, something that I'm looking forward to be honest, because there are some intricacies that I have to worry about. And one of the problems is that this castle, and in the planning of this whole thing, that the castle itself lines itself up with a lot of different other parts of the palace. And so I've been trying to go around and mark off important locations that I think that I'll be having to connect things up with. And so getting that all out of the way is going to be really important, especially over here, because this part, this small castle that connects to this castle, a lot of complex pieces here, but this castle will connect to the palace, another palace part right over here. As you can see, it's massive in scale, and it's gonna take a while to build. So lots of content to come from this series for sure. And you can see some of the planning of the crenellations right here, these little places where I put the smooth sandstone, kind of denote where the ribs of the crenellations are gonna be. And so a lot of planning here and not a lot of detail as of yet. Working out where everything's going to go is going to be very important. There's going to be another castle element right over here, and it's to take advantage of this hillside, and we're kind of building with the terrain in mind. That's going to be very important. What we're going to do now is we're going to go off and take a look at some of the other things that I've been working on. It's not just the castle I've been doing, but I did want to focus most of the episodes that I'll be doing right now on the castle, because I really do want to finish it. I want to finish a project at some point in my YouTube career here, if you can call it a career. But we'll take a look at some of these other things, and I'll be right back with you. All right, so the next stop on our tour is the palace structure itself. I've been kind of remodeling it, and the reason why is that this whole thing used to be under a different texture pack, this whole world. And so a lot of the design choices that I made were based on the textures in that texture pack, and it was a nice texture pack. It was a BD Craft Spax BD Craft. Really great texture pack. You should check it out yourself if you ever get a chance. But I decided to switch over to the default texture pack just to make it easier for you guys to kind of follow along with how I design all these things. And in doing so, I've had to make some changes to the design, because it really the original texture pack, the BD Craft texture pack, I edited some of the textures in order to kind of fit my needs. And now going back to the default, it's been a little bit challenging to try and find bricks and blocks that kind of fit the look that I'm trying to go for. So you can see the difference right here, because I failed to edit in some of those changes here, which I'll have to do at some point. But it'll give a good contrast between what I had before and what I have now. So this right here is what I have now. These quartz blocks, these are pillar quartz blocks, and it's real handy in that it's a nice vertical pattern going up. So it kind of really shows off the verticalness of the entire structure, and I wanted to keep that in there. And I wanted a nice white here to balance out with the yellow of the sandstone. I don't want the entire palace to be yellowish in color. I wanted some white in there just to give it a little bit more texture. The glass itself, it is the stained glass pane, and it's the light gray texture, and that is because it's a little bit dull in terms of the actual details that are in it. And you can see the difference. Look at the difference in between it. This glass, it's got a lot of texture in it, it's got a lot of details in it. Most glass in real life doesn't really have these details. They're all put in here just to kind of show you that it's glass and you're not walking into it all the time, because it's plain old clear. Most glass has some sort of reflection, and you can sort of tell when there's glass there. That's kind of like the difference. And if we can ever get Minecraft to have reflections and glass, I think that would be a real big game changer in terms of the design of all these glass structures. And so the light gray stained glass pane works out quite well for us. Again, nice and mute. It doesn't take away from the design at all. I mean, if you take a look at this one down here, you got all that details and stuff, and I don't want that in there. I just want a nice plain glass window. Don't need all the textures and all that stuff. And for the pillar quartz block, I'm forgetting my names already. I used to have the iron blocks, and they look different in the old texture pack. And this one, though, in this texture pack, it doesn't really look that great. I didn't wasn't really working with my eye, and so I had to change it. And of course, in here we have the chiseled sandstone, and I just replaced it with a regular sandstone. I didn't want the I really don't like the creeper face in the chiseled sandstone. It's pretty unfortunate. I wish I could make it into something else. I wish they would make it into something else, but I kind of get the fact that it's a detail block, and it's not really something that should be used over and over again, kind of like what I have here. And what else did I have going on here? I think I'm going to be replacing the what's this called? Glowstone. The glowstone will have to be replaced somehow. I'm thinking about resetting it into the block somehow, kind of like this. We'll take away that and maybe that. And then I just need a glowstone brick, and we'll put it in there like so. And then maybe have like a birch fence in front of it, because I don't like the texture of glowstone too much. And that was one of the reasons why I switched to BDcraft, was that their glowstone and was a lot better in texture, and I could change it. So I kind of made it my own. So the idea going forward is that this glowstone will have to be hidden away somehow. I do like the lighting of it, especially at nighttime. It'll be real key for us, but I don't like the texture of glowstone. So trying to hide it here and there will be a real sort of challenge for me. And I'm thinking that I have some ideas, and that's one of them. But as far as anything that's permanent yet, I'm not too sure. But that's pretty much it for this. I have replaced a lot of the brick. I used to have brick in here, the red brick, and I've since changed that all to the stone brick stairs. It's kind of plain looking. I might have to play around with it a little bit more. I'm not too sure how it's working with my eye, but that will all come in time. And so, yeah, that's it for this part. On to the next area. All right, and this is our last stop on the tour. You can see a whole bunch of orange wool around me, and I'm planning out the spacing for all the pillars that are going to be going in this area. And this place has been heavily inspired by my trip to Paris, and I'll tell you all about that. But we, in terms of where we are in this world, that's the castle down over there. If my rendering distance can catch up with me, the castle is just down there, and we're pretty much on the other side of the palace. There'll be more palace over here, and then there'll be a castle somewhere in this area, and then over there you can see the Oasis Project. So we're right smack in the middle of all these things here, sort of. I don't know, but over in that direction will be more palace and a possible museum that I'm thinking about making. That's all in the future plans. That's something that I haven't even gotten around to thinking about really. And down over there is our very snazzy hall. If we can get down over here, take a look at that. Still looks the same. And again, with the whole design of the exterior of the palace, I've been trying to hide the glowstone, and in doing that, unfortunately, it'll have to intersect with the interior design of this. So I'm thinking about possibly, I'll show you where I'm thinking about, or where the glowstone kind of intersects. It's right here. See this strip right here? Right along here and right along there. I'm hiding it right now. You can see it there with these the wood stairs. The idea is that I want to try and cover up all this glowstone, because all this has to go. All this has to go, unfortunately. So we'll have to take away some of the details, but I'll have to fill it in with an interesting design. And going for it, I think doing something like this, it might work for us. It looks a little bit too busy, but I think that it's something that I'll have to battle with here and there. I did like how it was before, the fact that it had this little kind of framing in here, but you know, in designing a lot of things, there's going to be a lot of give and take, and for this design, you have to kind of battle with the exterior and the interior, and these walls are actually pretty thick. You can see about 3 blocks thick, just the wall itself, and then there's some detail elements that come into play on the inside, so it's about 5 or 6 blocks in thickness, but even then, I still kind of run into problems when I'm trying to design a lot of things. There's a lot of compromises that you have to make in order to come up with a decent design. But I always try to make sure that I'm, you know, giving myself enough room for a lot of these design pieces, because you never know when you're going to need a detail element here or there. So this orange wool, like I said, planning out this whole courtyard right here. And this was all inspired by my trip to France. More importantly, Paris, because that's where I went. But in fact, a lot of this palace has been inspired by the Palace of Versailles. And this is one of the courtyards in the Palace of Versailles. And I was thinking about making something like this. So the palace itself kind of juts out here, this palace. I'm not talking about Versailles. And then there'll be a lower courtyard, which was inspired by the Palace of Versailles itself. And it was a really cool area to take pictures. And I think I have a whole bunch of pictures of my wife with a little umbrella. She was very cute. But yeah, it's something that I was really taken aback by the detail of it. There was a garden right over here, and I'm thinking about making something like that. This area is going to be really important going forward, especially next week if everything goes well this week. It's going to be a real awesome time for us. And this area is going to be very important when it comes to doing all of that. And in the middle, what I'm thinking about making is some sort of glass structure. And it's all inspired by the Louvre. I don't know how to say it properly. But the Louvre in Paris, they have a glass triangle structure in the middle, and it's in the middle of the courtyard of the entire museum. And it was built, I believe, in the 80s. And it was a very striking structure in that you had all these palace elements, which were of a Baroque, French Baroque theme. And then in the middle, you had a big giant glass pyramid, which is very stark. A very stark contrast between the detailness of the Baroque, and then you have the kind of simplicity of the pyramid in the middle. And I really like how that all works. I like mixing in the new with the old, and that's going to be something that going forward you're going to see a lot with the whole palace elements. I'm going to try and mix as much of the new with the old as possible. So I'm thinking about making some sort of pyramid structure. You know, I'm going to try and make it as different as possible, and that may be inverting it. Instead of having a pyramid that goes up like so, I'll invert the pyramid to go down in the middle, and maybe not make it a pyramid. I might make it into a dome-like structure, and then down below that, if I can get... Oh, I don't think I tunneled it out yet. No, I didn't tunnel it out. But going into here, there'll be other elements, possibly an underground area that I think that will lots of room to build things. So and lots of orange wool around here. I'm planning out a lot of the structure and how it's going to be. That giant circle up there is kind of like a planning thing for myself. to kind of get my bearings on where I need to be placing blocks, especially with circular elements. That's going to be something that's very important. But yeah, that's pretty much an update of this entire world. I'm going to have to end it here. This is pretty much just an update episode for you guys, where we get back in another episode, the next one that comes out, which will be on Thursday. It's going to be 2 days from now. So this entire week, we're going to be concentrated on this Surviving Creatively series. And then the next week, we'll be kicking off with another series for the rest of that week. It's part of this whole new format. If you haven't seen the video that I talked about, all this stuff in before, I'll leave a link in the description below. It's not really that important. All you need to know is that I'm kind of starting up with a new format, and hopefully everything goes well. But yeah, we're gonna have to leave it there. I thank you guys so much for watching. It feels so great to be back. I'll tell you what, it feels so great to be back. And I'm glad you guys are here along with the ride with me. So don't forget to leave a like. Click the like button if you so choose. Leave your comments down below. Tell me what you guys think about this whole world. Maybe some ideas that you might have to incorporate into this. I love hearing you guys tell me all about that stuff. And if you're new to this channel, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. So that's it for me. Always remember, keep your head up. And I will see you in the next one.